in the past, we've had our share of tiffs. But I truly believe it's because you misunderstand me. I am not interested in a relationship of artificial pleasantries and phony smiles. You never, ever have to pretend with me. I'm always honest with you, aren't I? And if I see something that you desperately need help with, like cooking, cleaning, the children, your hair. I care so much that I have to say something because I want to help. Oh, honey, you don't have to be worried, dear. I forgive you for today. And I'm always here to help.
Can I ask you something?
Anything, dear.
How do I look to you?
Why, are you sick? Oh, you don't look so good.
Mama.
Oh, no, you don't look good. Oh, you're pale and your eyes are sunken in. What's the matter?
Nothing.
Oh, don't lie to me, Raymond. You look awful. We'll have some raisin toast.
Well, you must stop it. I'm not sick, okay? This is how I always look. But thank you.
So then what is it?
I was wondering. Between Robert and me.
Well, where is Robert? He called last night. He said he wasn't coming
home.
Yeah,
he had a date.
He did?
Yeah.
Robert had a date? Who is she? Oh, I would have ironed a shirt for him. I mean, they could have eaten here. I would have made something special. Why didn't he tell me he had a date?
Because of this.
This is so delicious. You really got it, kid.
You really think so?
This is a beautiful thing.
Thank you, Frank.
Listen, Marie, this is not what it looks like.
I'm not talking to you. I do have a question for Deborah, however. What have I done that you feel the need to destroy me?
What?
Who told you about Prajol?
Nobody. I found a recipe in a magazine.
You found a recipe? Oh, you're a cook now. Frank never mentioned Prajol to you?
No.
No.
No, I didn't say a thing, Marie.
Quiet. Frank never told you that Prajol was the very first thing I ever cooked for him?
Oh, boy.
No, I didn't know that.
You didn't know that? Do you know what he said to me when he tasted my Prajol in 1955? He said, "Be my bride."
Marie, come on.
Be my bride, Frank. Be my bride. But it's very clear now that you'll go to any girl with a pot.
Sorry. May I help you?
We can handle it, Jeeves.
We're just checking these.
Well, I can assure you they're all exactly like the display model.
Well, see, here's one where the pamphlet's a little folded.
What are you doing? That's not a believable complaint.
It's perfectly valid.
Can't you ever just be quiet?
Don't you tell me to be quiet. I have a mind of my own, you know. I can contribute. I'm not just some trophy wife.
You're a trophy wife? What contest in hell did I win?
One day this would happen.
Man, what a day. I had this interview with Ewing, you know, and he's late. He's 3 hours late, and I had to wait for him. Oh, I am tired, sweetness. Oh, yeah. Oh. Oh, baby, does that feel good? Oh. Come here.
trying to help you relax.